New details about the gunman behind the Washington Navy Yard massacre. Reports indicate he struggled with mental illness, hearing voices in the days leading up to the attack. That information is reviving the gun control debate, and the shooting is raising another big question. Are America's military bases vulnerable? A new report from the Pentagon says they are. There is something broken when it comes to security on U.S. military bases, and according to a new Pentagon report, it is the screening process for contractors. The report was underway even before the attack at the Washington Navy Yard, and the inspector general found convicted felons routinely gained access to military facilities, just like Navy Yard shooter Aaron Alexis.
Mr. Alexis had legitimate access to the Navy Yard as a result of his work as a contractor, and he utilized a valid pass to gain entry to the building.
Alexis was first granted secret-level security clearance in 2008. Somehow, he was able to keep that clearance, despite being discharged in 2011 and facing several run-ins with the law. Now, Defense Secretary Chuck Hagel is ordering U.S. military installations around the world undergo security reviews. Lawmakers on the left are using the Navy Yard shooting to revive the debate over tougher gun control. President Obama is pushing for Congress to revisit gun control legislation. He says stricter laws could make the U.S. less vulnerable.
The fact that we do not have a firm enough background check system is something that makes us more vulnerable to these kinds of mass shootings.
But not everyone agrees, and some feel military bases are actually targets because service members are not allowed to carry weapons on base to protect themselves. Jesse Jane Duff of Concerned Veterans for America told CBN News more weapons might help.
However, I do feel that your senior level staff, non-commissioned officers, and your officers should be allowed to carry. It just would make sense.
The Navy Yard attack has prompted at least three new investigations into government and security background screenings from the Navy as well as the White House.